Cinestill 800T. It's one of my favorite films, mainly because it's a tungsten film, so its white balance is more towards warm light, yellow light, so indoors. On the actual scale, it's 3200 Kelvin, whereas daylight is 5500, 5600, depending who you're asking. What that means is basically if you took this outside and just started shooting photos, it'd all turn out blue. But if you came inside under some yellow light bulbs, everything would look nice and exactly how you would want it to look. So what we're going to be doing is comparing Cinestill 800T to Kodak Vision 3 500T. What's interesting is these two are actually the same thing. So what Cinestill does is they purchase Kodak cinema film, movie film, and they buy it in the large rolls, they cut them, and they put it through a chemical process to remove a layer called Remjet. So what's the difference between these two rolls? This still has that black layer on it. So I get these from the folks over at Film Photography Project. They re-roll these themselves, but they don't remove that layer. What that means, I'll go ahead and put an exclaimer here, is you need to develop these by hand yourself so you don't ruin an entire lab's developing equipment, because it's this really black, thick, nasty stuff. That being said, the reason I'm contrasting both of these is that Remjet layer prevents the halation that you normally see in Cinestill. Really bright red flares or glows around light sources or really bright areas. According to the Cinestill folks, back of the camera reflects enough light that it actually makes this a little bit more sensitive without the Remjet layer. I'm gonna test that theory out. I'm actually going to set both of these in cameras at ISO 500 with the exact same exposure settings, and we can put them side by side and take a look. This is an 85B filter. What this does is it takes tungsten film, warms it up about to the temperature it would need to be for daylight photography. I'm gonna try to push it to its limits and see which one comes out on top. Okay, let's check out the scans. All right, so this was taken at a local diner called J-Boy's or Jerry's, and it was taken in tungsten lighting, so the white balance right off the bat looks pretty good. So we've got Vision 3 here on the left, Cinestill on the right, and that's how all of these side-by-sides are going to be. So let's take a look at some of the differences, some of the things that are the same. Right off the bat, I noticed that we're getting a lot more contrast on the Cinestill than we are on the Vision 3. The darks are darker and the lights are lighter. Other than that, they're pretty similar, at least in this example. Interesting to see right off the bat that the contrast is so different between the two. All right, so another example. Shot in the same diner, Vision 3 on the left, Cinestill on the right. Wow, there's a pretty significant color cast. It looks like Vision 3 is actually handling the yellow light a little bit better, and Cinestill is a little bit warmer. Actually, it honestly looks like Cinestill is a little bit more red or magenta. Overall, besides that, contrast is maybe a little bit higher on Cinestill. Let's take a look at the next shot. All right, so looking at the tiles in the back, we are seeing that color cast still. It does look like Cinestill is a little bit warmer in this example. Looking at like the neon lights on Vision 3, we're seeing it capture those highlights really well, and Cinestill is a little bit brighter. And you could go back and say, well, that's why they say, meter it at, 800 for Cinestill. But when I look here where the plates are in the shadows, I'm actually getting those shadows are a little bit darker on the Cinestill. So it's not necessarily
an exposure as much as it is the contrast. At least that's what I'm seeing so far. All right, there's an interesting shot. So Vision 3, CineStill. What's great is we can actually put these a little bit more side by side. So color cast, obviously still there. We've got some halation around the light, obviously. Looking at the fact that this was metered probably a little low. When we're looking at underexposure, it looks like Vision 3 is actually handling it a little bit better. The grain is consistent, and you know, it obviously does have a blue color cast to it. But when we look, you know, we compare this Vision 3 to CineStill, CineStill's got a lot more grain. It looks like the grain's a little bit larger, a little bit more dominant. Combination of red and blue grain that we're seeing here. And I'm guessing again that has to do with that anti-halation layer. It's introducing a lot of reds, and when it's underexposed, we're getting those purple shadows. All right, here's another shot. So Vision 3, CineStill. Vision 3 looking like it's actually pretty well balanced, maybe a little bit green, a little bit blue for what it seemed like by my own eye when I was there. And then CineStill, we are seeing a little bit brighter of an image. I'm actually not seeing as much darks, but it does still seem to be a contrast issue. All right, so moving outdoors, this is obviously mixed lighting. We're gonna see a couple different light colors. So Vision 3 on the left, everything overall does look pretty blue. I'm guessing, you know, tungsten was really based more towards older style light bulbs that were a lot warmer, a lot yellower than what we see even today. When I look at things like the fast food signs, it looks like that's still nice, bright and white, but it's almost like a bluish white. Taking a look at the CineStill, we're getting a little bit more of a real to life representation of the lights. So obviously we got a lot of halation around those light sources, but I actually prefer the colors on this a whole lot more, especially when you look at the tiles, for instance, inside the Waffle House. The first image is a little bit closer to white. It still is leaning heavily towards the blue end. Looking here at the signs for the other restaurants though, so if I was to pick between these two, I think the white balance on CineStill kind of hits the nail on the head. All right, so this is my friend Savannah. She offered to help me in my little quest here to compare these two films. Again, left is Vision 3, right is CineStill, and this was fluorescent lighting. But it looks like CineStill is picking up that green light that you tend to get from fluorescent light better. And what's nice is because it's picking up more warmer tones, you're also getting that red in the clothing as well. All right, so here is another shot in fluorescent lighting. Obviously, Vision 3, still pretty blue, but when we go over to CineStill, that actually looks really good. It's capturing all that green light, and I love the tones in this. It looks very, you know, cinematic, which you would kind of expect from CineStill. So I'm really digging that. Besides the color cast, I'm not seeing too much of a difference. Maybe a little bit more of that red, blue, purple grain on the CineStill side of things. Other than that, looking pretty even for exposure and for contrast. So here's another one. This was kind of more of a halation test. So looking at Vision 3, you can see that we're not getting any halation. You can take a look at the strands of hair and the light coming through it. We're pretty good. But looking at the halation, you're getting that red glow around your subject or around those light sources. Again, that's not necessarily a bad thing. I think for me, if I'm shooting tungsten and I am not wanting that halation, I'm gonna go with Vision 3 every time because the difference is pretty dramatic. Let's keep going here. All right, so we're moving outside. So we're now in daylight. So Vision 3 and CineStill. Now, this is without any filters, without any color correction. We're getting that redder tone from CineStill, and you can tell which one's CineStill with all that halation and that red glow. So what I did is I took this shot without any filters, and then I retook them with filters. So what you're seeing now is Vision 3 with an 85B filter that's supposed to warm it up to about of daylight. So here's Vision 3, here's CineStill. Wow. CineStill is really getting closer to the tones that I personally prefer, a little bit more accurate, even though it does appear that the halation with the filter is a lot more predominant, the filter on. Overall though, we are still seeing a little bit more grain in the shadows, but they look pretty similar in the exposure and in the contrast. All right, so the rest of these daylight shots are all with the 85B filter. So with this being Vision 3, looking at the skin tones, really the overall image obviously is a lot bluer, but surprised to see how much red is brought into these shadows. Just kind of emphasizing again, you're gonna be pulling a lot more red into your images than you'd probably expect for a tungsten film. All right, here is another shot here. Really dig this one. We're seeing better skin tones. But what's great is you're still getting a lot of blue on the CineStill image, so the colors coming out are pretty great. All right, so here's an image we saw earlier, but I wanted to show you the difference of before and after I did some color correction. Here is my before and after. This is just my personal preference. So I liked to warm it up and get it to still retain a lot of that cinematic quality. And you know, I didn't adjust certain colors. I just adjusted the overall tonality, mainly with a focus towards skin tones. So in summary, I would say there's always room in my camera bag for Vision 3 or CineStill. I'm going to keep shooting them both. And it's great because now I can kind of know what to expect and what to use when. Thanks everybody for watching. Feel free to drop any questions in the comments. Big shout out to my buddy Uriah for the beats. Tagged him below in the description. I've also tagged the Instagram for Savannah and my Instagram. So thanks again for watching, guys, and get out there and shoot some tungsten film. Give it a shot yourself and let me know what you find out. I'd love to hear your guys' feedback.